When you think competition, you may think Super Bowl or World Series or the U.S. Open in golf or tennis. Forget it. This is competition. Our Little Miss is a story we first broadcast back in September of 1977. It was an examination of the competitive spirit at work as applied by 11 and 12-year-olds, even 3-year-olds. It's a zany, perhaps even a bizarre bit of American folklore. For us and the little women involved, it's a stroll down memory lane. These are not the finals. It's only the beginning. One of 250 local contests to decide who gets to one of the 33 state finals, and from there, to the world finals in Niagara Falls.
Jolene is 6, sponsored by Controlled Irrigation of Selma. Her favorite foods are tacos and ice cream cones.
This is Selma, California, the self-proclaimed raisin capital of the world. They're picking a 3 to 6-year-old to be Selma's Miss La Petite, and a 7 to 12-year-old to represent Selma in the Our Little Miss division.
One of the little girls up on stage this evening will be awarded the Personality Plus Award. That's given for personality and sparkle. The Selma Miss La Petite is Kimberly Graham.
Four-year-old Kimberly Graham has reached the first run. She has won in Selma. The pageant system works roughly the same as the McDonald hamburger business or the Midas muffler business. Women all over the country buy a franchise from Universal Pageant System. And in return, they get a load of crowns and scepters and trophies and the right to hold a competition. Parents pay for the right to compete, anywhere from $25 to $200 a time. There are dozens of different companies that hold pageants, but according to parents who make a career out of the pageant business, Universal is the most prestigious. The total package, says the company, meaning the little girl, should be natural and should smile. Always smile. And so, finally, Niagara Falls, where 200 little girls and attendant mommies and daddies and grannies have come to vie for the two most coveted titles in kiddiedom, the world's Our Little Miss and Miss La Petite. A great natural phenomenon meets a great social phenomenon. It took nature perhaps 200 million years of grindingly hard work to carve out this great gorge. It took mommy perhaps 2 or 3 years of equal determination to create these little winners.
Here's an Edwardian treated little party dress. The high-rise, tiny little ruffles around her neckline, and same little treatment travels right over the bodice, right on down to the skirt line. About the double rows of soft baby lace is trimmed the pink silhouette. And a high-rise flyaway bow is in the back. She's a package of beauty, a package of loveliness, and she deserves a great big hand. Another beauty. Wow. Here's a delicate blonde beauty, ready and trailing right into the judge's scorepad for her points in front.
This is Uncle Lin. He's been doing this for 11 years, and as far as can be determined, has no second name. He's the master host at the Our Little Miss pageant. He is armed, in his words, with a .45 caliber smile, and he packs an automatic charm.
That's a blonde beauty if there ever was one.
Miss number 36, tell us your name, where you live, and how old you are, please.
World, by world they mean the United States, as in World Series, is a week of days jammed together with excitement, fear, hope, and frustration. The girls must be on at all times, for if the judges notice some less than poised, unsmiley behavior, even in the halls of the motel, it can affect the final decision. The tension among mummies is unbearable. Everyone else's little precious looks like a princess, and yours looks like a frump.
They're being chosen now on their poise, their personality, their skin tones, their chosen natural hairstyles. They have just enough glitter in their eyes and their eye contact. You know, most of them have learned that a smile is the most contagious thing they can give anyone, so they're giving that contagious smile to the judges. It's worse than measles, mumps, chicken pox. When a little girl smiles at you, you gotta say yes.
We are looking for what we call a package. We like a little girl who has a little bit of everything, and we are not looking for the affected child. Of course, the people know this. We want more the natural type.
Contests like Our Little Miss do not just happen. They are the fruits of an idea. An idea that was born in the brain of Marge Hanneman, president of Universal Pageant System, who is known by everyone as Supermom.
We want a girl that we can take into a room full of people, where she'll smile and look like a little girl and act like a little girl. We don't want her wearing a lot of stage makeup or anything like that. And we want one who is pretty enough that people will notice her.
The talent part is the most excruciating part. It is the part that separates a champion from just another pretty hairdo. Courtney Kaufman, age 9, is an old trooper. Her mother may be nervous, but she is made of sterner stuff. Judith Kaufman is thrilled to tears with Courtney's performance. But if you scan the audience, you will find a more critical pair of eyes. They belong to Joan McCauley. Mrs. McCauley makes an unofficial book on each of the contestants. It enables her to assess the chances of her own daughter, Nikki McCauley, age 10. The McCauleys spend a good part of the year going from pageant to pageant, motel to motel. It may look dreary to some, but the McCauleys love it. They've spent thousands so far, but the sacrifice has been worth it. Nikki is St. Louis and Missouri, Our Little Miss. And the scuttlebutt at Niagara Falls is that little Nikki is to be feared.
There are some people that push their children. Those children will never be winners because they don't want to do it. Your really true winners are the ones that want it. And the children that don't, they soon get out. Because it's like Little League. There's the stars. And there's the kids that play because their daddies want them to play. And then you've got the kids with the natural ability that usually keep going and then usually turn professional or if they're good enough, you know. Okay, give me some showmanship. Come on, project. Just keep that body up. Hold it up straight. Let them know who you are.
Here is Nikki McCauley.
I think we have the sort of idea of a certain kind of woman, the stereotype of the kind of driven woman who is driving her child on.
I'm a stage mother, and people kid me about it that aren't into pageants. They say, you know, that Larry and I, we're stage parents. And that's fine. I think that's the greatest compliment in the world, because my child is out there on stage, and she has performed for thousands and thousands of people. And been, you know, and does commercials, and we hope that soon that she'll, you know, will be either in New York or in Hollywood. And when you say stage mother, that's me.
When you're going into a competition like this one, can you psych yourself up? I mean, can you psych Nikki up? Can she psych herself up?
Oh, yeah. We start weeks before.
How do you do it?
I tell her she's a winner, and she knows she's a winner. And if she doesn't win, the only reason she doesn't is because the judges didn't like blondes, or they didn't like her type.
What's going through your mind when you walk up on that stage?
What's going through my mind is I want that title really bad so I gotta do a really good job for my parents, and maybe the judges will let me have that crown.
How many trophies have you won?
142. Mm-hmm.
Another powerhouse at Niagara Falls is Cynthia McAvey of Ohio. So far, she's won 872 trophies, and she's only 11. And she says she could walk away from it all anytime she wants to, that her mother has nothing to do with it.
She wouldn't even care if I quit baton twirling. She might be a little disappointed, but she wouldn't be really mad at me, but I don't want
to
quit.
If I said I wanted to quit baton twirling, my mom said, "You mean I spent all that money on
right.
You don't let me."
I've never been to a pageant before, but is it a little bit phony, do you think?
When you're in the room, you can do anything you want. Beat on the bed, whatever. Jump on the bed. But when you're out of the room, you have to ask, "Nah, nah, nah, nah."
It would strike me that they're asking you to act like grown-ups rather than keeping you as little girls.
Uh-huh. Walk straight, poise, beauty, smile.
So when in doubt about what to do, finally comes the night. The night of 1,000 tiny glittering teeth, of smiles smiling as they have never smiled before. Of the last few moments of anonymity for two little girls and the heartbreak of defeat and permanent anonymity for the rest. Dorothy Collins, Giselle McKenzie, and Snooki Lanson may only be nostalgic memories for some of us, but the fourth member of your hit parade lives on. Russell Arms has become the Burt Parks of the teenies. And tonight, their fate is in his hands.
Our third alternate, number 76, Margaret Whitehead.
For Joan McCauley and Little Nicky, it is a night to be forgotten. They didn't make even the top 10. Perhaps the judges didn't like blondes.
And our winner, and new 1978 World's Our Little Miss, number 19, Karen Evans.
Thank heaven for little girls. For little girls get bigger every day.
The motto of the competition is, a winner never quits and a quitter never wins. There may be some wisdom in that homily, but you can't help but wonder whether it makes any sense to a three-year-old girl. But that doesn't matter, for, as Mrs. Hanneman says, it's not a girl, but a package they're looking for. The only trouble is, thank heaven for little packages doesn't rhyme. Also, packages don't cry.
No matter where, no matter who, without them, what would little boys do?